Hey guys, welcome to Initiate Scientia, where science meets you.
Synthetic fibers and plastics. The clothes which we wear are made of fabrics. Fabrics are made from fibers obtained from natural or artificial sources. Can you name some natural fibers? Fibers are also used for making a large variety of household articles. Make a list of some common articles made from fibers. Try to separate them into those made from natural fibers and those made from artificial fibers. Make entries in table 3.1. Say table 3.1, serial natural and artificial fibers. Serial number 1, name of article, type of fiber, natural or artificial. Why did you label some fibers as artificial? You have read in your previous classes that natural fibers like cotton, wool, silk, etc. are obtained from plants or animals. They are synthetic fibers, on the other hand, are made by human beings. That is why these are called as a synthetic or man-made fibers. What are synthetic fibers? Try to recall the uniform pattern found in a necklace of beads joined with the help of a thread, or try to join a number of paper clips together to make a long chain, as in figure 3.1b. Is there any similarity between the two, beads and paper clips joined to form long chains? A synthetic fiber is also a chain of small units joined together. Each small unit is actually a chemical substance. Many such small units combine to form a large single unit called a polymer. The word polymer comes from two Greek words, poly meaning many and mere meaning part or unit. So a polymer is made of many repeating units. Types of synthetic fibers. Rayon. You have read in class 7 that silk fiber obtained from silk was discovered in China and was kept as a closely guarded secret for a long time. Fabric obtained from silk fiber was very costly, but its beautiful texture fascinated everybody. Attempts were made to make silk artificially. Towards the end of the 19th century, scientists were successful in obtaining a fiber having properties similar to that of silk. Such a fiber was obtained by chemical treatment of wood pulp. This fiber was called rayon or artificial silk. Although rayon is obtained from a natural source, wood pulp, yet it is a man-made fiber. It is cheaper than silk and can be woven like silk fibers. It can also be dyed in a wide variety of colors. Rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets or mixed with wool to make carpets. And nylon. Nylon is another man-made fiber. In 1931, it was made without using any natural raw material from plant or animal. It was prepared from coal, water and air. It was the first fully synthetic fiber. Nylon fiber was strong, elastic and light. It was lustrous and easy to wash. So it became very popular for making clothes. We use many articles made from nylon, such as socks, ropes, tents, toothbrushes, car seat belts, sleeping bags, curtains, etc. Nylon is also used for making parachutes and ropes for rock climbing. Figure 3.4. A nylon thread is actually stronger than a steel wire. Let us find out. Polyester and acrylic. Polyester is another synthetic fiber. Fabric made from this fiber does not get wrinkled easily. It remains crisp and is easy to wash, so it is quite suitable for making dress material. You must have seen people wearing polyester shirts and other dresses. Terlin is a popular polyester. It can be drawn into very fine fibers that can be woven like any other yarn. My mother always buys PET bottles and PET jars for storing rice and sugar. I wonder what PET is. PET, polyethylene terephthalate, is a very familiar form of polyester. It is used for making bottles, utensils, films, wires and many other useful products. Look around and make a list of things made of polyester. We wear sweaters and use shawls or blankets in the winter. Many of these are actually not made from natural wool, though they appear to resemble wool. These are prepared from another type of synthetic fiber called acrylic. The wool obtained from natural source is quite expensive, whereas cloths made from acrylic are relatively cheap. They are available in a variety of colors. Synthetic fibers are more durable and affordable, which makes them more popular than natural fibers. You have already performed an activity of burning natural and synthetic fibers, activity 3.6 of class 7. What did you observe? When you burn synthetic fibers, you find that their behavior is different from that of the natural fibers. You must have noticed that synthetic fibers melt on heating. This is actually a disadvantage of synthetic fibers. If the cloths catch fire, it can be disastrous. The fabric melts and sticks to the body of the person wearing it. We should therefore not wear synthetic cloths while working in the kitchen or in a laboratory. Oh, now I understand why my mother never wears polyester cloths while working in the kitchen. Characteristics of synthetic fibers. Imagine that it is a rainy day. What kind of umbrella would you use and why? Synthetic fibers possess unique characteristics which make them popular dress materials. They dry up quickly, are durable, less expensive, readily available and easy to maintain. Perform the following activity and learn for yourself. Activity 3.2. Take two cloth pieces of the same size, roughly half a meter square each. One of these should be from natural fiber, the other could be a synthetic fiber. You can take help of your parents in selecting these pieces. Soak the pieces in different mugs, each containing the same amount of water. Take the pieces out of the containers after 5 minutes and spread them in the sun for a few minutes. Compare the volume of the water remaining in each container. Do synthetic fabrics soak less or more water than the natural fabrics? Do they take less or more time to dry? What does this activity tell you about the characteristics of the synthetic fabrics? Find out from your parents about the durability, cost and maintenance of these fabrics compared to the natural fabrics. Plastics. You must be familiar with many plastic articles used every day. List of such items and their uses. Plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. All plastics do not have the same type of arrangement of units. In some it is linear, whereas in others it is cross-linked. Plastic articles are available in all possible shapes and sizes, as you can see in figure 3.7. Have you ever wondered how this is possible? The fact is that plastic is easily moldable, that is, can be shaped in any form. Plastic can be recycled, reused, colored, melted, rolled into sheets, or made into wires. That is why it finds such a variety of uses. Now try to bend a piece of plastic yourself. Can all the plastic articles be bent easily? You will observe that some plastic articles can bend easily while some break when forced to bend. When we add hot water to a plastic bottle, it gets deformed. Such plastic which gets deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastics. Polythene and PVC are some of the examples of thermoplastics. These are used for manufacturing toys, combs and various types of containers. On the other hand, there are some plastics which when molded once cannot be softened by heating. These are called thermosetting plastics. Two examples are Bakelite and melamine. Bakelite is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. It is used for making electrical switches, handles of various utensils, etc. Melamine is a versatile material. It resists fire and can tolerate heat better than other plastics. It is used for making floor tiles, kitchenware and fabrics which resist fire. Figure shows the various uses of thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Plastics has materials of choice. Today, if we think of storing a food item, water, milk, pickles, dry food, etc., Plastic containers seem most convenient. This is because of their lightweight, lower price, good strength and easy handling. Being lighter as compared to metals, plastics are used in cars, aircrafts and spacecrafts too. The list is endless. If we start counting articles like slippers, furniture, decoration pieces, etc. Now let us discuss the characteristics properties of plastics. Plastic is non-reactive. You know that metals like iron get rusted when left exposed to moisture and air. But plastics do not react with water and air. They are not corroded easily. That is why they are used to store various kinds of material, including many chemicals. Plastic is light, strong and durable. Talk to your parents or grandparents about the types of buckets that were used in the past. What is the material of the buckets or mugs you are using today? What are the advantages of using a plastic container? Since plastic is very light, strong, durable and can be molded into different shapes and sizes, it is used for various purposes. Plastics are generally cheaper than metals. They are widely used in industry and for household articles. Make a list of different kinds of plastic containers that you use in daily life. Plastics are poor conductors. You have learned above that plastics are poor conductors of heat and electricity. That is why electrical wires have plastic covering and handles of screwdrivers are made of plastic. As mentioned above, handles of frying pans are also made of plastics. Plastics and the environment. When we go to the market, we usually get things wrapped in plastic or packed in polythene bags. That is one reason why plastic waste keeps getting accumulated in our homes. Ultimately, plastic finds its way to the garbage. Disposal of plastic is a major problem. Why? A material which gets decomposed through natural processes such as action by bacteria is called biodegradable. A material which is not easily decomposed by natural processes is termed non-biodegradable. Type of waste, approximate time taken to degenerate, nature of material, peels of vegetable and fruits, leftover foodstuff, etc. 1 to 2 weeks, biodegradable, paper, 10 to 30 days, biodegradable, cotton cloth, 2 to 5 months, biodegradable, wood, 10 to 15 years, biodegradable, woolen cloths, about a year, biodegradable, tin, aluminium, and other metal cans, 100 to 500 years, non-biodegradable. Plastic bags, several years, non-biodegradable. Since plastics take several years to decompose, it is not environment friendly. It causes environmental pollution. Besides, the burning process in the synthetic material is quite slow and it does not get completely burnt easily. In the process, it releases lots of poisonous fumes into the atmosphere, causing air pollution. How can this problem be solved? Avoid the use of plastic as far as possible. Make use of bags made of cotton or jute when you go for shopping. The biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste should be collected separately and disposed of separately. Practice this in your homes. Can you suggest some other ways in which you can contribute towards reducing the use of plastic materials? It is better to recycle plastic waste. Most of the thermoplastics can be recycled. Make a list of items that can be recycled. However, during recycling, certain coloring agents are added. This limits its usage, especially for storage of food. As a responsible citizen, remember the 5R principle. Reduce, reuse, recycle, recover, and refuse. Develop habits which are environment friendly.